What about the wicked stuff? You know, at the end of Religulous, I say, if you belong to a social club that contained as much violence, anti-women, anti-homosexuality, just plain wiping out people, genocide for no reason, you would probably resign from that social club.
I think a lot of the question about sort of religious history, right, in part it comes down to your view of human nature. If you think human nature is, you know, pretty much okay, and then you look at religion, you say, well, here comes this force telling people to believe in their sky fairies and their flying spaghetti monsters and so on, and it's yes, taking people and it's making them kill each other and so on. On the other hand, if you think, as I do, and I think it's borne out by a lot of empirical evidence, that people are mostly pretty, they're most of the time, independent of whether they're religious or not, then you look at religious history and you say, well, wait a minute, okay, yeah, obviously it's justifying genocide here, but people commit genocide without resorting to religion for justification. What's interesting is the moments when religion comes in and lifts us up.
That's not quite true. Actually, the opposite is true. Someone once said, to have a normal person commit a horrible act almost never happens without religion. For how people get on a plane and fly it into a building, it had to be religious.
I think what's true is to get a normal person to commit a crazy act, it does take ideas, right? But those ideas can be secular as well as religious.
Boom. Roasted.
A lot of normal people did.
Mostly in history, they did.
Not in the 20th century. Not in the Soviet Union. A lot of dead bodies there.
Right.
Boom. Roasted.
Not a lot of Christians, except among the dead bodies.
Boom. Roasted.
How can otherwise very intelligent people, and that's why I'm glad you're here, because that you certainly qualify. Again, you wrote that column for the New York Times when you were 9.
It was a good year.
How can otherwise intelligent people believe in the talking snake? You must know, because you're a student of history, that other civilizations had supernatural gods, and we know now that they're myths, or we could describe them as myths. We think Zeus is a myth. We certainly think Thor is a myth. We now have supernatural gods. You must, the rational part of you, see that pattern there.
Right. The pattern is...
The rational part of your mind must see that pattern.
The pattern is this, right? People find themselves in a mysterious and mysteriously orderly universe. They find themselves equipped with sort of intense moral instincts, and they have religious experiences, and they develop systems that explain those. And over time, Christians think that God, you know, intervenes and sort of reveals himself, and that's why we have sort of progress in religion. But even, I think the point I would make, Bill, is just, you know, you ask how an otherwise intelligent person can believe in something metaphysical. But human beings are believing animals, period. You were talking about secular religions. Even, you know, secular liberals have their, you know, where are human rights, right? What is the idea of universal human rights if not a metaphysical principle? That you can you find universal human rights under a microscope? Is it in the laws of physics?
Boom! Roasted!
Were you for killing bin Laden when Obama did that?
Yes.
Because certainly, if you read the New Testament, on many pages, Christ says, do not repay evil with evil. Do not kill your enemies. Turn the other cheek. Tell me how you lawyer your way out of that. No. How can you be for something that your savior, the guy you emulate and want to follow, when he says specifically so many times, do not repay evil with evil, do not kill your enemies, turn the other cheek. How is killing bin Laden? Now, I'm for killing.
I think the thread that runs through the New Testament is, you know, there's also a
But strong... you know those quotes.
Well, there isn't a quote that says, you know, civil authorities have no right to kill a mass murderer if he's guilty of mass murder. There are quotes for sort of, in ordinary life, Christians are supposed to turn the other cheek. But Jesus was pretty friendly with a lot of Roman soldiers. And there was Christianity's always developed a just war tradition that says there are situations where, again, civil authorities, not you or I going off with a machete in, you know, the Northwest frontier, have the right to preserve civil order.
Boom! Roasted.
I'm going to ask you one more question before we move on, because I could talk about this all night.
And
you're a
and for all
you're a very good
too.
Sparring partner. But so
boom, roasted.
Boom, roasted.
Boom, roasted.